Hi everyone, welcome on board to Helpper.tv, where you get the reliable news that is tailored for you, and of course where you can actually comment and interact.
Mayeti Allah said they are not rapists, they are not criminals, and they are not kidnappers. And you'll be shocked at the people and the state they claimed rapists are from, criminals are from, and kidnappers are from. The Mayeti Allah leader, who regretted that their members were also aiding and abetting criminal activities, said the action of some of their members was portraying the entire Fulani in a bad light. Mayeti Allah Cattle Breeders Association of Nigeria, MACBAN, has fought back over claims that Fulani herdsmen are criminals. The group claimed most kidnappers and rapists hail from Zamfara State, Niger State, Kaduna State, Bauchi State, and last, the state of the president, Katsina State. MACBAN chairman in Nasarawa State, Alhaji Muhammad Hussaini, accused visitors from far north and their children of causing problems in the state. Most of the kidnappers in the state were from Zamfara, Niger, Kaduna, Bauchi, and Katsina States, among others, who have caused security problems in their respective states. Who said at the meeting of MACBAN in Lafia, Nasarawa State Capital, the Mayeti Allah leader, who regretted that their members were also aiding and abetting criminal activities, said the action of some of their members was portraying the entire Fulani in a bad light, and they've now been branded kidnappers and armed robbers and rapists. He called on every Fulani family to expose criminals amongst them rather than keeping them, to show the whole world and to show Nigerians that they are good and respectable people, peaceful people. Majority of the kidnapped victims are Fulani people, because our people are living in the bush and are vulnerable to the activities of the criminals, he claimed. So the question we want to ask is this: what about the ones in the south? Are they also in the bush? The MACBAN chairman said Nasarawa State belongs to them, hence the need for all leaders of the socio-cultural group to re-strategize and expose bad elements among them for prosecution. He said, how can we allow a few strangers from other states to tarnish our image? Look at what happened in Udege, local road, where these strangers, our children, together with some indigenous tribes of the area, whisked away 30 people to an unknown destination. Let us re-strategize. If your son, brother, or anyone you know is among these bad eggs, bring them out or the law will take its course on you. Hussein listed illiteracy and hard drugs as a major factor pushing people into crime, hence the need for security agents to rise to their responsibility of reducing crime. Lawal Dono, chairman of ADOS in Nasarawa State, said as leaders, they would not harbor criminal element. He said that they would direct their people to provide security agencies with relevant information about criminal elements, since they are the ones in the bush. Leaders of some of the local government chapters of MACBAN in Nasarawa State said some arrests were based on their efforts, challenging other tribes to complement the efforts of security agents in the fight against insecurity and to find a way of cleaning up the name that has been put on them. And reactions trailed all of these things. Some people said, well, God should help everybody, that we have bad people that are Muslims, bad people that are Christians, bad people that are Fulanis, bad people that are, you know, from the south. You know, people started acting like, well, maybe they've said something. MACBAN is the cause of the crime in the country, that 75% of other countries, of the crimes in Nigeria are from this Fulani terrorists. That yes, we have issues, we have other criminals, but the activities of the Fulanis of the north has now become very tough, and it's like certain groups of people are even hiding under that Hausa Fulani to commit crime. That's what someone here said, that they should go back to their country. Where do you think Fulanis are from originally? If you know where Fulanis are from, they speak Fula language, you find them in Gambia, you find them in the west of Africa, you find them everywhere. They are in Nigeria, and Nigeria is one of the countries where they've dominated, and they are in government. Right now, Buhari is a Fulani man. Some say he's an Hausa man, but whatever it is, they are the ones in government. Where did the Fulanis originate from originally? Where did they come from? So they said they have achieved what they want politically, and that they should go back to their country. that those who brought them cannot feed them. The only options for them is to kill, kidnap, and commit other crimes. I'm simply saying that other Fulanis came from other countries. They stepped into Nigeria, and now they've been used for probably elections. They've been used for whatever it is. They've told themselves that there is free grazing in Nigeria, that Nigeria is a lawless country, that Nigeria is a place where the president right now is from their region. He lost cows more than people, so we can move in and do whatever we like. Now, they cannot control them. Now, someone said that, are you saying that they are not murderers and they are not criminals? That they are wasting lives of people going into other people's farm and doing all sort of very terrible things. And you said that they are not criminals, that they are criminals. That those that have been arrested should be presented to the public. They should be made to confess. And definitely they will tell. How can rearing of cows and animals be the interest of everybody or the government itself? It should be the business of whoever is involved in it and not a business of everybody. So I don't know what your take is as regards this. They said that Fulanis do not forgive, they are wicked people, and they started naming some other people that are Fulanis that are part of Nigeria. And you know, there are a lot of people saying that there should be an end to the rulership of Fulanis, that Fulanis, that the only people recognized in Nigeria is Hausa, the Hausa in the north, and there's nothing like Hausa Fulani. It's the Hausas, but the Fulanis came in and they brought in the religion, and they used this as an avenue to kind of penetrate them. And ever since, they dominated the Hausas. Hausas do not have voice in the north no more. It is only the Fulanis that have the voice in the north. They took over from the Hausas. They made Hausas their carpet, their stools, and they sat down on them. And they are trying to muscle themselves over the rest of the south. And this has brought about people asking for a break away from Nigeria. And they say they do not want this present system. They don't want any of this. But do you think that that is a solution, a breakaway? Or do you think that there is another way? Drop that also in the comment section. And what do you think is a solution to these issues of insecurity at the moment? We've heard cases of setting chiefs, monarchs in the southeast of Nigeria, who collect bribe from those Fulani men, and they give them places, they give them lands that have issues on it already. They give it to them and also allow them to go in because they've been given cows, they've been given money. So it's very deep. So it's not just the Hausa Fulani, it's also the person inside that is selling you out also. Someone said generation comes and goes, but the earth remains infinite. Magban is in a little while, you'll be no more in either through disintegration, or your backbone, who is General Muhammadu Buhari, will expire and you will join the likes of Abba Kyari and co. Had it been Fulani started their evil activities today, we would have listened. Fulani came to Nigeria through killing of innocent people, continued deceiving the gullibles. We know you guys. You are Lucifer. You are Satan. The identity of the murderous gangs are being revealed, but no one is doing anything about it. It takes a thief to know the trail of a thief. The seeds of criminality had been unwittingly sown by a successive military regime in this country, and nothing good would have come out of decades of deprivation and massive looting of commonwealth. Religious bigotry, ignorance, uncontrolled breeding, and anger are deadly mixture. The consequences of years of neglect are here with us. The only remedy is social justice. Bullets and tanks can only suppress but not cure the ills. It's a terrible thing. It's a terrible thing. I do not see why Fulanis, if they are in Nigeria and they've kind of integrated themselves, although violently, into the structure and the strata, I do not know why they cannot have their own ranch. You should have your own ranch. Your ruga should be where you live. If you are going to have a ranch outside of the north, then it would be people selling you that space, and you have to keep to the laws. And the laws of the land, of that state, of that region, of that village, of that town. You cannot move around from one point to the other, feeding on other people's farm produce, and you bring out weapons and guns, and whenever there is something, you call your leadership and say, oh, they are doing this to us. This is not right. Their reign will soon be over, as someone said, and hopefully so, because we have seen governors in the southeast of Nigeria that are cooperating, and they are praising the activities of Fulani herdsmen. Now, despite admitting that its members do these crimes, why haven't these members been classified as terrorists? These are terrorist activities. These things, they say, is just to distract people from the main fact, although they've described terrorism as people, a terrorist as someone who wants to have his own sovereign state in a state and pushing for whatever it is, that's just their own definition. Very, very wrong.
I say a very big thank you to those who have taken time to subscribe to this channel. And if you're yet to subscribe, kindly tap on that subscription button and also the red bell icon so you will be notified whenever videos such as this are uploaded.